We are going to present the second problem now. I am going to give you the second problem now. The second problem goes like this. I am going to share the screen again. This is the screen. What is given? In a quadrilateral ABCD, AD equal to BC. AD equal to BD it is given. Sorry, AD equal to BC. It should be BC. Let me write it. This is BC. Okay? AD equal to BC. These two sides are equal. Angle DAB, this green angle, is equal to angle CBA, this angle. These two angles are equal. What we need to prove? Okay? Required to prove is triangle ABD, triangle ABD, that is the triangle, children. Triangle ABD is congruent to triangle ABC, this triangle down. So two triangles are just kept one like a scissors, it is kept like this. You see here ABC is red marked and ABD is again down below this triangle, and BD equal to AC. BD, this is the line BD in triangle ABC. ABD is equal to AC, that is the side, corresponding side of triangle ABC. And ABD, angle ABD equal to BAC. What are those angles? These angles. See, are you able to see the blink there? One pink colored and one blue colored. That pink colored angle is in the triangle ABC and blue colored is in triangle ABD. So ABD, angle ABD is ABD, that belongs to triangle ABD, and angle BAC, that belongs to triangle BAC. These two are equal, we have to prove. For proving like that, now we take the sides. Of course, first step we will take these two triangles, we choose triangle ABC and triangle ABD and BAC. In that, AD equal to BD, that is already given, and this angle in that one triangle is equal to this triangle in this triangle, that is DAB in triangle ABD is equal to angle CBA in triangle BAC, and AB is equal to BA. Can you tell me why? The reason AB equal to BA, this side. Can anybody tell me what is the reason for the third one? Can anybody tell me why AB equal to BA? Putesh, Bhavya,
sir, CPCT, sir.
No, AB equal to BA, this side equal to this side. That is a common side in both the triangles. It's a common side. It's a common side, yes, in both the triangles.
Okay, sir.
I did not write the reason for this because I want you to tell that. It is a common side. In both the triangles it is there. Therefore it is equal. So then, therefore, three corresponding parts are equal. One side, angle, another side. And this is included angle. Two sides and one included angle of triangle ABD are correspondingly equal to two sides and the included angle of triangle BAC. Therefore, these two triangles are congruent by SAS congruence rule. So automatically, you can say other two things will follow. BD equal to AC CPCT. What is BD? This side is equal to this side in the other triangle. And ABD, the side, the angles are also equal. You can see the blink. They are equal because of CPCT. You understand? That is the thing, children. So this is how we can easily talk about these triangles and their congruency, right? Now you may take a screenshot or write down the question quickly. Note down the answer quickly. Then we move on to question number 3. and remember, I am going to send this as PDF again, of course, but before you have to that, before I send the PDF to you, you should finish writing in your notebook. That is always better. You will do, you will make your notes on your own. Now, we are not, I am not giving any homework today, children, because homework once a week I am giving as per the instructions by Principal Madam. Therefore, what I tell you is you practice on your own. I need not tell you specially you have to practice them. Practice them on your own. Every problem is important from this exercise, because they may, any question may come in the exam, either in the final exam or PTs, anywhere. So be ready for that. Now, coming to the next question, we'll close this. Next, we'll move on to question number 3. Question number 3. I am opening that question, you please hold on. In question 3, two line segments BC and AD, BC and AD are given perpendicular to the same line AB, and that too they are equal. BC and AD, they are equal and they are perpendicular to this line AB, this line segment AB rather. Okay, now we have to show that CD, this line segment is bisected by this line segment AB. What is the meaning of bisection? Making exactly two equal parts, making that line into two equal parts. This line segment AB makes line segment CD into two equal parts. That is what we have to prove. For that, so you can see what is to be proved. These two, this line segment is bisected by this line segment. Now let us go for step 1. In these two line, now we will start comparing these two triangles. Triangle BCQ, BCQ, this triangle, and triangle ADQ, triangle ADQ, this triangle. These two triangles are to be compared, and given that CBQ is equal to DAQ, because they are, each is perpendicular to this line segment, so each angle is 90 degrees here. Perpendicular means it is at right angle, so these two are right angles, that is compared first. And given that this side is equal to this side, now we need one more extra equality to prove that these two side triangles are congruent. Can you tell me, Hamasrinath, can you tell me which part can be equated in these two? Can you tell me?
BC and DA.
BC and DA, you know, BC and DA, that is given already. That is already given, it is, I wrote here. Anything else?
CD and BA.
CD and BA. CD and BA. How can those two, they are sides, they are simply line segments. They are not sides of any triangle. Bhuvanyasri?
BQ.
No, one more.
BQ and QA, sir.
BQ and QS. That is BQ and QS. How can you, BQ and QA?
QA, sir.
That is to be proved actually. That need not, that is, of course, that is not given. We don't know about that. Bhuvanyasri, Ganesh, you can closely observe the screen. There is a hint on
the angle QBQ is equal to QAD.
QBC is equal to QAD. That is already given here. No, not that. Come on, Karunya, Akshaya, Bhargav, hint is there on the screen. You can observe the screen carefully.
CQ is equals to QD, sir.
No, no, it is, I'll tell you. Okay, now let us not waste the time. Here the hint is given, children, see here. Vertically opposite angles. Angle BQC is equal to AQD. Vertically opposite angles, they are equal. See, only this is, this can be taken because other things are not given to us. If at all we want to take BQ and QA, it is not given that they are equal. We cannot take that. This angle and this angle, we don't know whether equality of those two angles. And CQ and DQ, that is to be proved, okay? And we don't know anything else except this one. This one is very easily understood, that the vertically opposite angles. Are you able to see the blink there? Right. Now, that is BQC is equal to AQD. They are vertically opposite angles. They are equal. Therefore, these two triangles are equal by, I wrote AAS or AAS here rule, both are same. Here it is AAS because angle and the side is not included, some other side, non-included side. So two angles and one side, therefore we can say AAS. Therefore the triangles are congruent to each other. When they are congruent to each other, the corresponding sides CQ and DQ, they are equal. When they are equal by corresponding parts of congruent triangles, we can say this line segment CD is bisected, exactly made into two parts by this line segment, exactly equal, exactly bisects. So did you understand the question here? It is simple to write, but a little bit of difficulty is there, to understand it. Come on children, note down, all of you note down please. Note down. Everything you have to remember, what exactly you have to prove, what is given, all that. Now, shall I move on to another question here? Meghna?
Yes,
Meghna?
Yes, sir.
Following? Okay.
Yes, sir.
Yes, one. Yes, sir. M.S. Vant, did you write this? Yes, Vant?
Sir?
Did you write this one?
Sir, I take a screenshot, sir.
Ah, but when are you going to copy it?
I will copy after one,
after
the class, sir.
Oh.
Sir, after the class.
It's okay, but after the class, you have continuous classes. Here after, next time, tomorrow onwards, keep the notebook with you. Keep noting down immediately. That is better. Ravanth,
okay,
did you finish
sir.
Writing? Ravanth.
Sir.
Did you finish writing?
Sir, I take a screenshot, sir.
Amma. Amma. Technology, huh? Wow.
Sir.
But you have to submit the classwork whenever I ask you. Don't get
okay, sir.
Dev Kumar, how about you? Dev Kumar.
Over, sir.
Over. Did you finish copying? Okay. Now, let us start, do the next one. Here we go for the next one. Question number 4. Question number 4. Here we move on to question number 4. Question number 4. A set of parallel lines L and M are intersected by another set of parallel lines P and Q. P and Q. See, the green colored are one set of parallel lines and the black colored are another set of parallel lines PQ. And the points of intersection are marked as A, B, C, D. AC is joined. By joining like this, we form two triangles, triangle ABC. Triangle DAC or CDA, triangle ABC and triangle CDA, and we are to prove that these two triangles are congruent to each other. So that is what is asked here. L and M, it is L children, not I and M. It is L and M are two parallel lines intersected by another pair of parallel lines P and Q. We have to prove that triangle ABC is congruent to triangle CDA. So firstly, what all we can understand? See, here the angles here. The angles are there, two angles. Okay, firstly we'll verify whether these two triangles are really congruent or not. We'll try to verify it. I have made a small arrangement here to check whether these two triangles are congruent or not. Now all of you observe, children, I am trying to move triangle ABC. Triangle ABC I am moving and trying to put on triangle CDA, and that is matching like this. Is it matching?
Yes.
Have you seen
yes,
this?
Yes,
yes, sir.
Once again,
yes, sir.
I am bringing it. Very good, Dinakar, you have marked it. Purnachandu, are you observing? You have to observe and tell me now. Purnachandu, Supriya. Now you see, I am moving triangle ABC slowly and trying to put on CDA, and I am putting it slowly like this, and it is exactly matching. And the triangle CDA is not appearing, it is superposing. Therefore, these two triangles are congruent. We can easily say that they are congruent. Okay, you could observe this one. Now, it is, of course, practically I have shown you this practically, but how to prove it theoretically? That is the question now. So let us talk about the angles here now. Angle 1 and angle 2. Angle 1 is in triangle ABC and angle 2 is in CDA. These two angles are equal to each other. Can anybody tell me what is the reason?
Sir, alternative integral.
Very good, very good. Who said this?
Alternative.
Who said this one?
Karunya, sir.
Very good, Karunya, very good. 1 and 2 are equal because they are alternate, a pair of alternate interior angles. You can see BACD. It is making a Z here. So, and they are these two pair of parallel lines. AC is taken as a transversal, therefore they are alternate interior angles and they are equal. Now see these two angles here, angle 3 and angle 4, they are also equal. I say, why they are equal? They are equal.
Alternate interior angles.
Very good, alternate interior angles. Who said this one? Who said?
Ganesh, sir.
Good, Ganesh. Then, very good, Ganesh, you have to answer one more question for me now. Alternate interior angles formed by, what are the parallel lines? Which parallel lines are making those? And which transversal is making those angles?
Parallel line
AC is the transversal.
Parallel lines P and Q, AC is the transversal. Therefore, these two are congruent. These two are equal. They are 3 and 4 are also equal. Now this line is a common and equal. It is a common line segment, common side in both the triangles. Two angles are correspondingly equal. Angle 1 and 2, angle 3 and 4. And one side is common. So that is an included side. Therefore, you can easily give the proof like this. In triangle ABC and CDA, angle 1 equal to angle 2, alternate interior angle. Angle 3 equal to angle 4, again alternate interior angles. And AC equal to CA, it's a common side. Therefore, the triangles are congruent by ASA congruence rule. ASA congruence rule. So, you all keep noting down. I will take the attendance through my app here. So, keep doing quickly. of course I have to join through the mobile. I'll join now. Please note down quickly, children. While noting down, you can observe for quick noting. Drawing you may do it at a later stage. Drawing you may do at a later stage because drawings are given in your textbook. The answer you note down in simpler words quickly. Okay, that is better. Now I will stop the screen share. Shall I stop the screen share?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Very good. Very good. I am hiding this. Stopping. Now, when I stop this here, I can go back to normal.